So here in this video we will discuss about the lumbar pedicle screw entry points and the trajectory. So briefly summarizing the lumbar vertebra anatomy first. So anteriorly we have the body of the vertebra, then posteriorly we have the two pedicles from the posterior lateral margin of the body. We have the two pedicles of the vertebra, which is the strongest part of the vertebral column. Then moving more posteriorly we have the two facets. We have the superior facet and then we have the inferior facets. So the bony part joining these two facets is known as the pars interarticularis. Going laterally, we have a small projection known as mammillary body, which is basically remnant of the transverse process of the dorsal spine. And more laterally, we have the transverse projection, which is known as the transverse process of the lumbar spine. So this transverse process of the lumbar vertebra is basically remnant of the ribs of the dorsal spine. And moving more medially, we have the two laminas. These two laminas, they join with each other to form the spinous process. So spinous process in lumbar vertebra, it is a tongue shaped, it is broad and it is directed posteriorly. While in dorsal vertebra, it is pointed and it is directed inferiorly like this. And also the facets, in lumbar vertebra, we have the facets which are in the sagittal plane for the flexion and extension of the body. While in dorsal vertebra, these facets are in the coronal plane for the rotation of the body. Now talking for the pedicle screws entry points, so we have three methods for the entry point. So first is the intersection method. So intersection method is basically intersection of the two lines. The first line is from the midpoint of the transverse process. So this is the one line, and second line is from the lateral margin of the superior facet. The point where these two lines meet is known as the intersection point. That is the first method for the entry point marking. Second method is the mammillary body. This projection is known as mammillary body. So this is the second method. We can locate the mammillary body and we can nibble it out, and then we can go through this point. This is the mammillary body point for the entry point of the pedicle screw. Third method is the pars interarticularis method. So we will trace the pars interarticularis laterally, and the point where it meets with the superior facet, that is the third point for the entry point. So we have three methods. We have the intersection method, we have the mammillary body method, and we have the pars interarticularis method. We trace the pars interarticularis laterally, and the point where it meets with the base of the facet, it is the entry point. Now after the entry point, we need to know the craniocaudal angulation. So if this is the cranial part of the body and this is the caudal part of the body, so this angulation is known as the craniocaudal angulation. So this is the craniocaudal trajectory of the pedicle screw. And the third point to note is the medial lateral angulation. So this is the midline of the patient, and this is the medial part, and this is the lateral part. So this angulation is known as the medial lateral angulation. So as we move downwards from L1 to L5, both these craniocaudal and the medial lateral angulation, they increases. So this is the chart which we will refer to. So this is the L1 to L5. So we have discussed the entry point. It is the intersection method, mammillary body method, and the pars interarticularis method. Then we have the craniocaudal angulation. So this craniocaudal angulation for L1 and L2, it is 0 degree. Then for L3, it is 5 degree. For L4, it is 10. And for L5, it is 15 degree. So this is the craniocaudal angulation. So for L1 and L2, we will go at 0 degree. For L3, we will tilt it caudally by 5 degree. And then for L5, we will go 15 degree, for 10 degree. And for L4, we will go for 10 degree. And for L5, we will go for 15 degree caudally. So this is because as we move from L1 to L5, there is increase in the lordosis. So for L5, there will be maximum lordosis, and we will go for 15 degree of the craniocaudal angulation. So our hand will be directed from cranial to caudal position. Then we have the medial lateral angulation. So medial lateral angulation also increases as we move from L1 to L5. So for L1, it is 0 to 5 degree. L2, it is 5 to 10 degree. L3, it is 10 to 15 degree. L4, it is 15 to 20 degree. L5, it is 20 to 25 degree. So this is the medial lateral angulation. So for L1, it is roughly 0 or 0.5 degree. और 5 डिग्री। एज वी मूव फ्रॉम L1 टू L2 वी इंक्रीज बाय 5 5 डिग्री। सो L1 इट इज 0 to 5, L2 इट इज 5 to 10, L3 इट इज 10 to 15, L4 इट इज 15 to 20, एंड L5 इट इज 20 to 25। सो फॉर L5 इट विल बी मीडियल लेटरल एंगुलेशन ऑफ 20 to 25 एंड क्रेनियोकॉर्डल एंगुलेशन ऑफ 15 डिग्री। सो दिस विल बी द ट्रेजेक्ट्री फॉर द L5, मीडियल लेटरल एंगुलेशन ऑफ 20 to 25 डिग्री एंड क्रेनियोकॉर्डल एंगुलेशन ऑफ 15 डिग्री। सो इफ यू विल बी नोइंग द एंट्री पॉइंट्स, द क्रेनियोकॉर्डल एंड मीडियल लेटरल एंगुलेशन, वी विल ईजली पुट द पेडिकल स्क्रू फॉर द लंबर वर्टिब्रा। सो आई विल अटैच दिस चार्ट इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन एज वेल एज इन द फर्स्ट कमेंट। थैंक यू।